Hello everyone. So today we are live and we are back, and of course we are going to create something new and exciting today. So now, one of the very basic thing what we need when we are saying a mixed media and a decoupage work is a texture paste and a modeling paste. Now this has been asked by so many people around, that what is modeling paste, what is texture paste, what is difference in that. And even on our previous live sessions we could see so many people asking that. So I just thought we will start this session with the very basic texture making. Now if you switch to my YouTube channel, that is in the name of Growing Craft, there you can see that my tutorials have some other something really interesting, where I have also shared my experiment on making your modeling paste, texture paste, gesso, your chalk paints, and even your DIY decoupage glue. So but today in the live sessions we are going to repeat that, and I really hope that will help you. Now the basic thing what we can start is to have the base for your modeling paste or the texture paste. Now for the modeling paste or the texture paste, what you need is a plaster of Paris, or you can use talcum powder. Okay, now what if you just have the plaster of Paris, you don't have the talcum powder, or you have the talcum powder but you don't have the plaster of Paris? It's absolutely fine, you can use any one of these and make your modeling paste or your texture paste. Now this is going to be the core ingredient. Now the second most core ingredient what we will be needing is this. It's a liquid adhesive, which is really important, because when we are doing our texture work, we don't want our modeling paste or the texture paste to just split out. So to bind it, we need liquid adhesive. So what I preferably use is Fevicol. Okay, now the third thing which we will be needing is this is white acrylic paint. Now if you have been to my channel, you must have seen that I have done two videos on modeling paste. Now in one video I had shown you how to make colorful modeling paste. So instead of white, you can choose any of the acrylic shades. Like you can choose any shade you want, but preferably it's good to have a white color modeling paste so that you can later on add on colors to that. So this is the third thing. Now the fourth thing what you will be needing is a clean tap water. Make sure that your water is really clean, and you will be needing this to mix everything. Now the last and the most important thing is to have an airtight container. Now many a times I have seen people making their modeling paste, texture paste, they keep it in a regular jar and then it dries out. Of course you can add water to it, use it again, but then the best thing will be to have an airtight container, so that your whatever the paste you are using, you will use it and then it is going to be there for the longer time. So this is the one of the airtight containers what you will be needing today. Talcum powder of any brand will do. Honestly, Shiba, I have tried with some of the very fragrance type talcum powder and the normal ones. Now this is the Johnson's one. So I'm not saying that you have to go for this brand. Any brand talcum powder will do. So at times I've even tried with the very fragrant ones, and I could really see that my project had such a soothing smell for a very 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 longer time. So definitely you can try that also. Girls, just once again I'll remind that we are having a huge giveaway for this live session also, so please do share this as much as you can. Okay, so now how to start with it. So let us do one thing, let us start with the talcum powder, and with this we are going to make our modeling paste. Now there is no difference in plaster of Paris and talcum powder when it comes to making your modeling paste. Now in a container, Now this is a container which I've been using for almost a year now, in which I make my modeling paste in a small quantity. I keep it. Whenever it's finished, again I make it and I use it. So I'm going to fill in approximately 2 spoons of talcum powder. Okay, now in this I will be adding up approximately 1 spoon of my white acrylic paint. So again, I'll repeat. First, I have taken up my talcum powder. Then I have added my white acrylic paint. Now, what we will need here is a liquid adhesive. You can take any of the adhesive, but Fevicol is something which I really like and I've been using this for years now. So yes, around 1 spoon of liquid adhesive, and now I'm going to mix it. And now for mixing this, I will add some water. Now water is something which you need to decide of your own. Usually when I am making my modeling paste or texture paste, what I do is I make it a little thicker so that whenever I use it, I can add some more water to it and change the consistency as per my project. Archana Gupta, how the modeling paste works? This is used to add some different dimension to your project. Now girls, in this one you have to make sure that you mix it really well, because we have already used so many different components here. I'll repeat it again. What we have used here is talcum powder, approximately 2 spoons of talcum powder, then 1 spoon of acrylic paint, then 1 spoon of liquid adhesive, and we have added some water to make it a nice paste. Now this is a very important step. You need to make sure that you mix it really well. This should mix really well. It should be like a, can you see this? Can you see this? This is so creamy. This is like a proper paste here. So this is how the consistency is. Now like I said, that I always prefer to have a little thicker paste. That's it. It's completely your choice. If you want a little thinner one, like if this consistency works for you, it's absolutely fine. But I like it a little thicker. So I am going to add some talcum powder here. If you don't have talcum powder, girls, I'm repeating this, you can use plaster of Paris. There is going to be no change or no difference in your modeling paste, so it's absolutely fine. Now after adding some more powder, the reason why I've added what powder is because I like the thicker consistency of my modeling paste. Now even with the different brands also, you get the modeling paste of different consistency. Depends on brand to brand that how is it working. So just mix it well. So earlier if you had seen, it was so creamy. Now it has become a little thick like a paste. So this is the consistency which I like. You can choose how you want it. Hiral, today we are making a modeling paste and we are going to create a beautiful, beautiful decor piece. So yes, here my modeling paste is done. Now, the second thing which has been asked many a time is that what is texture paste? Now, let me create it for you. Now, I have taken another container, okay? And now, in this, we are going to make our texture paste. Now for the texture paste, you can use any kind of granules, the stones, the pearls, and create your own texture paste. What I really like is this white color stones. I got this from a local store and I got a big bag of this, and these were of dirt cheap price. So what you have to do is take up some of your modeling paste and add any kind of texture to it. Like you can have nice fiber pieces, you can have these granule stones, you can have some pearls, you can have your deco stones and then use it. And now I'm going to mix it well. Again, you need to make sure that it should have mixed really well before starting the process. Now I just need to add a bit of water to my texture paste. Now again, I will be mixing it well. Let me show you what are these stones. So these are the fine stones which you can get from any of the marble or the stone shops. So, and these are dirt cheap. These are really dirt cheap. So I think one packet is for just 50 rupees, this size packet, 50 or 60 rupees, which is so much for using it again and again for your projects. Yes, of course, you can use sand. The thicker sand will work really well here. You can ask them for the tiny stones or the pearls. Even you can use the tiniest pearls what you get. If you check Craftologer, they have some nice, really beautiful pearls which you can absolutely use. Okay, so here my texture paste is done. Now let me show you the difference in the modeling paste and the texture paste. Shweta, you can just ask for the shopkeeper for any kind of tiny or the fine stones. And that will be like really workable when you are asking for any of the shopkeeper. Okay, so here I have taken up a white color paper base, and I will, let me take a colorful one so that it, I think that will be much more visible for you guys. Okay, so here I will be showing you that how it works. See, plaster of Paris dries out if you don't add all the steps what I have shown in this live session. So do check that. Do check that. Once the session ends, you can check this video and it will not dry out. I have been using this for almost 2 years now. Okay, so I will just do my texture work. So this is my texture work which I am doing on my plain cardstock. So while applying this, you will hear some noise. I'm sorry about that, but I can't help it. Okay, so now this is my texture work. Can you see some of the textures here? So all these are the texture, and these are something which really helps in like adding some extra drama to your projects for sure. So this is how your texture work looks. Now, what is modeling paste? We have already created this, our own modeling paste, and I'll show you now. Now I've taken my modeling paste and my palette knife and I'm just spreading it up. Okay, now let me show you closely. Okay, so can you see the difference in texture paste and modeling paste? I'll just write it down so that it's easier for all of you. This is texture and this is modeling. I'm so sorry for my bad handwriting, but yeah. This is how your texture paste and your modeling paste work. Girls, a little request, please do share this video as much as you can. So I hope making your own modeling paste and texture paste was clear to you, and you could see that how differently you can use them on your projects. Like what you need to do is create something beautiful, add your textures, add your modeling paste, and they are going to look fab for sure. If you guys have any queries, you can ask me and then we can start with our next step, and that is creating a beautiful project. Hi Bhavna. Uh, Shruti, you can always add some water or you can add some acrylic medium to your paste or your paints. Then they are not going to dry out at all. So if you go to the market, you can ask for this acrylic medium. This really works for any kind of paints, any kind of texture paste, any kind of modeling paste. And that is going to work really well. Yes, definitely we can add colors to it. So let me show you here. Now this is my modeling paste and let me add yellow color paint to it. So you can use any of the acrylic colors or your chalk paints, shimmer paints, shimmer sprays, any of those are going to work really well. Now here I have taken a small quantity of my modeling paste and I'm adding my color to it. Can you see? Can you see some nice shade on this? So this is how you can add colors to your modeling paste or your texture paste too. Let me take up some texture paste also. Girls, this is super, super, super easy with very basic supplies. Like during the lockdown, most of the things were not available. Shops were closed and there was a time when I did not have the modeling paste which I wanted. So I had created that of my own. And all those videos are there on my channel too. You can check that in the name of Growing Craft. Can you see the colored? This is a texture paste. This is a modeling paste. This is a plain texture and plain modeling paste. So you can create these of your own definitely. I hope this is clear. Swati, the texture has some extra dimensions to it and whereas the modeling paste is going to be really fine and smooth. And if you use it with your stencils, you can know that how beautifully it adds some more project. Nimisha, yes, yellow is one of my favorite color. Thank you so much, Jyoti. Thank you so much. Okay, girls, so now let's move on to our next step. And that is creating your own nameplate with some of the basic supplies. Now, whenever we say nameplate, the most important and the basic thing what comes to everyone's mind is that from where will I get the name cuttings? From where will I get the MDF cutout of names? How do I do it? And the best part of creating a nameplate is that you can play around with so many things that you really don't have to worry about that. So like girls, I always say that with the very basic supplies, you can create anything really beautiful. So today we are going to do that on this live session. Girls, please do check my Growing Craft group on Facebook. That's in the name of Growing Craft, where you can share your artwork and we will be more than happy to get inspired from your project. So please do join our Facebook group too. Now, this is one of the MDF bases which I have for my nameplate. Now this is, if you see, this is approximately 5 mm thick and this works wonderfully for any of your nameplates. Now, how to add names to it? Okay, that's a very important thing. So what I love is, if I don't have the MDF cutouts or the cutting work, what I do is I create my own resin alphabets. So these kind of alphabets I make of my own. The video is already there on my channel. It's in the name of Growing Craft. And otherwise, what I love doing is to have such kind of prints. Now I'll tell you why I take out print in two different sizes. Now many a times what happens is that we have taken the font of the name in one way. The papers what we are using does not matches with it. So that's the reason I always try to have good 2-3 options. Like if you see, I have this one printed. I have so many prints like this which I keep really handy whenever I am making my nameplates. So Likewise, here I was not sure that how exactly I'm going to do it, so that's the reason I've taken the names in two different sizes and fonts, and I think I'll go with this one. So what we are going to do is, first we need to trim this up. If you have a paper trimmer, you can use that, but like I said, today we are going to do all the work with the basic supplies. So even with a scissor you can cut this, and can you see this fits really well, and I think this is almost the center of my page. Now next thing is to stick this. Now for sticking this, you can even use your liquid adhesive, but I prefer to use my flat brushes, and I try to stick these with my DIY decoupage glue. Now what I will be doing is, I will be sticking this complete paper. Why I'm sticking this complete paper and why I'm not doing the fussy cutting work, that I'll tell you later on, but right now we need to stick this paper on our complete base, and be a little generous whenever you are sticking up your papers and whenever you are applying your decoupage glue, because this is really important, and this is something which holds your project, this is something which holds your tissue, your papers and everything. So be generous with this, and I'm sure you will love the outcome. Okay, so I'm here done with the stick, applying my decoupage glue, and I will stick this one now. Now immediately I will start pressing this off really well so that there are less wrinkles. Now wherever I feel that I have not applied my decoupage glue, I will quickly brush it up. Now once you're done with this, you need to press it with a flat brush. Make sure you don't overrun your brush on your text, and once this is done we will let it dry completely. Yes, this is a very simple printout, so you usually get those JK papers and other print papers, and you take out the print normally on your normal printers, and that's absolutely fine. You can definitely use that for sure. You don't need any fancy printouts, because anyways later on we are going to cover these up with the other mediums too, so that you will see later on in this session. Okay, so here I am done. Now I will be using my heat gun to dry this up, and girls, I have already shared those videos where I have mentioned that why and how heat gun is different from your hair dryer. If you want just to dry it up, then definitely you can use your hair dryer, but heat gun has its own pros, and which is really important. Yes, this is just a very thin paper printout. See this one. This is a normal printout what we do at our home, so I always use this one. No, nothing. The more thinner the paper is, if you are doing this technique. See, even when you are making a name plan and you are sticking the names, there are going to be variations, like what kind of work you are doing. So for this particular technique, the thinner the paper is, the more beautiful it is going to look, and the more natural it is going to look. So I am using my heat gun to dry this up. So once it dries out a bit, then we are going to move on to the next step. Now I let it dry naturally for some time, and I'm going to keep it aside. Now we need to start with our decoupage work, and here I have such a beautiful napkin. Now we will do the cutting work, the same technique. The reason why I'm repeating the same technique today, so that I want you all to be really comfortable with this one, and you should know that it is not going to be very difficult for you all to trim out your designs from your napkins. Rita, yeah, it's an A4 size paper. I have cut it into the size of my nameplate, and now I have sticked it. Now let me trim down my papers, and by the time I can answer a few of your queries, it becomes really difficult to see the screen and do your work, cause I don't know, I get confused maybe. Girls, again I'll repeat, we have a huge giveaway with this live session too. So please do share this video as much as you can. Now I am trimming off all the papers. Now this has such a beautiful yellow color, but I thought of playing around with some other colors on my palette, my nameplate. So that's the reason I am not sticking this complete napkin. So this is not the only way of creating your nameplates. If you check to my if you hop onto my YouTube channel, you will see that there are so many ways of making nameplates. Like even in the decoupage, there are like so many ways on sticking it, having texture to it, having nice colors to it. So definitely that is something which you should try, and I'm sure you are going to love it. You can take up as many designs you want. If you want, you can have a plain single sheet and do the fussy cutting work. It's absolutely fine. It's just I am not very good with fussy cutting work. So that's the reason I prefer to do this brush and water technique. So this is a plain round paint brush. I'm just dipping this in a plain water, and I'm creating a border around my napkin. And once I'm done with that, then with my fingers I'm going to stretch it out, and it comes out safely. So here I am almost done. And I hope that this will turn out beautiful, cause I have, like usually when I'm doing my sessions, I don't make a sample piece earlier, cause the reason is that I want you all to know that while making, you get so many hurdles, you get so many like confusions whether to do this or not. And the best part is not planning too much and creating your project. That gives a complete different view and a complete different project on what you had expected. So do try this. I hope my sound is clear, girls. Just let me know if it's not audible. I'm not audible. Is it so? So I would just like to share that on our Facebook group, that's in the name of Growing Craft, there are some of the beautiful crafters who have shared their beautiful projects since yesterday, and we are completely in awe of those projects. Like they are absolutely gorgeous, and we would love to see some more projects on our group. So please do share your projects there, girls. We would love to see, and we are waiting to see your projects for sure. Thanks for confirming, girl. Now it's time to add some texture work. So today I have planned to use this stencil work. Now let me keep these napkins aside to dry out for some more time. And now it's time to use our own modeling paste. Yes, you heard me right. So just now in the starting of this session, we had created our own modeling paste, and today we are going to use that. And how exciting it is. It is so exciting for me that I have created my own suppliers, and I'm using it, and I'm making my own home decor piece, and it is such a satisfying thing to do. So now here I have my palette knife. If you don't have a palette knife, you can always take up any of your old credit cards or debit cards, even you can use that also. Thanks, girls, for confirming that my voice is audible. deco papers, like deco patch papers, you can get it from any of the stores, any of the good craft supply stores. There are many online stores in India, so you can check with them too. So girls, can you see that how creamy and how beautiful our modeling paste has turned out? So this is so amazing, and now we are going to use this on our project. So I've put up a stencil, and now I will be creating texture on the complete base. And now you will see, like earlier when we had sticked the paper, you could have seen this margin, but now once I do my texture work, you will not be able to make out if there was any difference. So that's the beauty of doing this step. Just be a little careful when you are doing this. Don't overdo the do the texture work, and it will be good to go. You can use this paper for sticking by your with your decoupage glue or your liquid adhesive. Any of those will be absolutely fine. So let me show you my texture work. Can you see this? Shiva, I would prefer that instead of having and going around for the cheap stencils, spend on a good quality stencil, then they are going to last long. Like for this one, I have been using this for almost 5 years now. And that's the reason it has been lasting, and I have used this for like 1,000 times at least, and nothing has happened to it at all. How to make the modeling paste, girls? We have just covered that in the starting of the session. Once I'm done with the session, then you can check the session from the starting and you will get to know. It's a super easy with a very basic supplies, and I would love to know if you are trying any of my techniques. Please do let me know on our Facebook group, that is Growing Craft, and we would love to know. This is so encouraging for us to know that you people are actually able to try out whatever we are making. So yes, I am done with my modeling paste work on this side. Once again, I'll show you that how beautiful this looks. This looks really amazing. I would have preferred to have a big A4 size stencil, but then again, the problem is even if we take A4 size stencils, they are on a vertical pattern and our nameplates are on a horizontal pattern. So it's really difficult to manage the design. So even these small stencils also work perfectly. It's just you need to be a little careful. Arrange it properly and you are so good to go. Now girls, when you are doing this, make sure you are not doing your stencil work on your names, because then later on it might be difficult for you to highlight them. Okay, now wherever if I feel that I have done it on my names, I'll just remove it with my palette knife. This is super easy. Even if you have done it on your alphabets, don't worry, just with your palette knife you can always remove that, and they come out very easily. Now my last portion is left and we are almost done here. So while we are doing this, girls, please help me out with what you would like to see the next. And yes, today again in the afternoon at 3 o'clock, we are coming live with another exciting project, and I would love to see you all there too. And I hope you have not forgotten about the bumper giveaway, which we will be announcing at 3 p.m. live session. So do join us by that time too. So here I am, done with my modeling work. This looks so pretty and so gorgeous. Yes, Archana, the stencil what I have used is really beautiful. I really love it, and I personally am a big fan of pinhole stencils. They are a bit expensive to what you get nowadays locally, but there is a huge difference in quality. Like I said, I have been using pinhole stencils for 5-6 years now, and nothing has happened at all. So I highly recommend you all to go for those kind of stencils rather than any of the cheap stencils or the one with the lower grade quality. So the texture work what we have done here is the modeling paste what we have made of our own. Now we will move on to removing our napkin plies. Again, I will be using my heat gun to speed up my process, and by the time I am also going to dry up my nameplate modeling paste. Girls, I really hope that you liked the session starting where we have created our own modeling paste and texture paste, and I hope I was very clear with what is the difference between these two. You can check Amazon for the stencils, you can check many of the craft supplies here in India for the stencils, and try for some really good quality brand. I would love to share the links once I'm done with this live session so that you can buy those stencils directly. Okay, now here we are done, and very quickly I need to remove all the plies. This is going to take a little time, girls. So by the time, if you girls have any queries, please feel free to ask me. I highly recommend Pinhole stencil. I absolutely love them. But there are many other Indian brands also, those who have come up with their stencils. You can check that too. So girls, like many a times I have been asked that, oh, making your nameplate, it is a difficult thing. It is a little tricky thing. No, it is not. It is one of the very simplest thing. It's just that you need to understand that how and when you are going to use your supplies and how the look and feel is going to be. If you understand this simple technique, it's going to be very easy. Tulsi, I have used my DIY modeling paste to stick. I have used my DIY decoupage glue to stick my paper to my base. And the base what I'm using today is an MDF base. If you don't have any of the MDF base, you can use any of the plywood pieces. Even that will also work really well. So I have done. If you hop onto my channel, you will see that I have used so many bases. Like I've done it on plastic plates, the nameplate making, then I've done it on plywood pieces, the scrap pieces and the MDF pieces, and all of them work perfectly fine. So don't worry about the base. If you have all the supplies and if you are making your own supplies, it's perfectly fine. You will enjoy making your nameplates for sure. Okay, so just a quick Anita, we can use chipboard, but chipboard are they are very thin. The strong you need some hard base so that whatever the nameplate you are making, it lasts long. So what happens is door plate is something which you hang outside your place. That means it will be much more exposed to the air, wind, sun. So that's the reason it's preferable to have a nice good quality MDF base or a good quality wooden ply piece. Girls, please help me out by sharing this video as much as you can. So now it's time to stick my decoupage napkin. But before that we have to play around with one more supply, and that is gesso. Now this is really important, and what you need to do is, if you want, you can create your own gesso. Like I said, it's already there on my YouTube channel that how you can make your gesso. I'll take some of the gesso here. Now I don't want my base to have the very bright white color. I want to keep it a little more natural, a little more woody effect. So I'm just doing a very light brush up on my panel. So what I'm doing is I'm just covering up the sides of my plate, the sides where I have not sticked my paper. Okay, and don't worry, even if you are doing your gesso work on the top of your modeling paste, it is not going to cover it all at all. Shibha, yes, I'm trying to be a little fast, but this will take a little time. I'm almost done, don't worry, we will be finishing this off very soon. If you don't want to cover this up with your gesso, it's absolutely fine. It's just that your base color will be a little more visible from your decoupage napkin, which is absolutely fine. Let me take some more gesso. If you don't have gesso, you can use white acrylic paint. Ankita, gesso is a medium which is used to prep up your base. Now what happens is that many of the mediums, like the bases like your plastic, your metal, they don't absorb the color, and even on the MDF they absorb too much of color. So how to solve that problem? And for that we use gesso. Also, before doing your decoupage work, it's always preferable to have your own white base so that your decoupage napkin colors can pop out really well. So here, girls, we are done with our gesso work. Now, very quickly, I know this is taking a bit longer than what I had expected, but I had to tell you everything step by step so that when you create your own nameplate, it works out well. Yes, Vinita, it is like a primer. Vinita, it's G-E-S-S-O. Yes, of course, Ragini, first you can do your gesso work. Is this that I missed out on gesso, so I'm doing it later on. And this is a good thing that I missed out, so that I could have told, I can tell you that even after you are done with your stencil work, your modeling paste and your texture paste, then also you can use your gesso. It's absolutely fine. Now here I am using my heat gun to dry this up, and yes, I am trying to make sure that it dries out well so that we can start with our sticking work. Hi Alicia, no worries girl, this session is going to be there on my channel, my page, so you can watch it later on also. Ankita, if you don't have a gesso, most of the beginners, if you are not having gesso, you can use white acrylic paint. But later on, as you go and start with your projects, you will realize that there is a difference in gesso and your white acrylic paint. So I'm not saying that you cannot use, you can use it, but there is going to be some difference. Yes, so I am done with my drying work. Now very quickly I'll take up my paint brush. I will take out all the excessive water. Now these are the plies of the napkin, and I always use this to clean up everything. Yes, Rekha, like I mentioned earlier also, you can use white acrylic paint too. Girls, a little reminder, please make sure that you share this video on many and different groups as much as you can. That will be a great help for me. And yes, we have a giveaway, a huge giveaway. Plus today we are also coming live at 3 o'clock with a bumper giveaway, so please do stay tuned. Okay, so we are starting with our decoupage napkin work, and you can see that even the sticking, just one single portion, and it looks amazing. This is looking beautiful. Let me stick this. So once you are done with your sticking work, with the same brush you can stick it well, and just make sure that it has sticked really well. There are less wrinkles and bubbles, and can you see the nice texture work here? this is just because we have done our texture work and then we are doing our decoupage work. So this is one of the techniques which is a little tricky. When you see it, you will see, oh, you might feel that, oh, it is a little tricky, but this is absolutely fine. If your modeling paste, if your texture paste has dried out, well, so you don't have to worry about anything. You can just go ahead and stick your napkin. It's just that don't rub your brush too much there. Okay, now here I'm done. Of course, I will be adding so many napkins now. Somewhere it's going to overlap on my names, but it's absolutely fine. Like, I'll just show you. Here it is overlapping on my names, the printed, but it's absolutely fine. Later on, we can finish that. This looks gorgeous. If you have any different color flowers or anything, you can try out with that, and I'm sure you are going to love all these effects. Now I will stick up this patch too. Even if it's overlapping with your another decoupage napkin, it's fine, don't worry. See here, you cannot even make it out that it's a two different pieces which we have sticked. No, Tulika, that was by mistake. Instead of my DIY decoupage glue, this is what I'm using. I just dipped my brush, so I'm not sticking this with the water. I'm really sorry. It was just that while talking to you girls, I did not realize that I just dipped my brush in the water. I'm so sorry for that. Now I will be adding some more pieces here and there. So I'm just trying to see that which one fits well here. So let me trim down this portion. I don't need a very big piece. So I've just cut this napkin. Now I'll be using this portion here. So can you see that it looks like a one single sheet which we have sticked here. Okay, now let me take up this remaining portion and let me stick it here. Even if it overlaps with your napkin, like I said, it's absolutely fine. Do not worry about that at all. Now here you can't even make out that these are two different pieces. They look gorgeous together. Now I will be taking few of the leaf pieces from here and I will be sticking it. Girls, I hope this video is clear to you all, and I hope that I am solving out all your queries. So even if you have some queries, you can later on also, you can comment on this video and I will help you back with all the whatever links and videos I can, so that it's easier for you to understand. It's not that once we are done with the session, then we are done. No, absolutely no, we are there for you. So if you guys have any queries, please do let me know. Feel free to comment on this video or on my YouTube channel and we will be happy to help. Now let me trim up this flower. I'm just trying to cover up something on the mid also, so that we don't have too much of empty areas here and there. Okay girls, so here we are done. Okay, now I am almost done with my sticking work. Now very quickly we need to use our heat gun to make sure that it dries out fast. Gitika, the paper for The paper what I've used in the base is the normal printing paper, and the napkin what I'm using is the decoupage napkin, the German napkins. And yeah, this is what I'm using. Which paper and glue you're using? I'm using my DIY decoupage glue. The video is there on my channel, on Facebook page also, so do check that. Girls, again a reminder, we have a huge giveaway with this live channel, live tutorial, so please do share this video as much as you can, and that really encourages me and that really inspires me to make some more sessions, some more videos for you all. After decoupage, after my texture work, I did my napkin work because I wanted my napkins to have these kind of texture. Can you see this? I hope this is clear. So what happens is, otherwise you are going to have a plain work, and if you do your texture work and if you later on if you do the decoupage work, it gives a very nice effect. Rekha, yes, absolutely. If you are very good with that technique, you can definitely write the names later on. But I'm not very good with the font painting work, so that's the reason I tried this technique. And this actually makes your work far easier than painting work. So this is what I feel. But if you want, you can try it out with any other mediums too. Okay girls, now it's time to move on to the next step, and for that we will be using our another glue, another shade, and I'm looking for my color. I'm actually trying to find my shade now. Oh yeah, so finally I got it. So this is the shade which I wanted to use today. Now, before doing the shade work, we need to again seal this up before. Now here what I will be using is my varnish. Now this is a water-based varnish, and we need to make sure that we apply this really well on our project. Why? Because the moment we start using shades and colors on it, these fonts are going to smudge because these are not waterproof papers. So very quickly, I'll just dip my letters with my varnish. Now I don't want to rub my brush on this, so that's the reason I am just brushing it up, and once I'm done with that, then I'm going to cover my napkin also. Now why do we need to do this? Because we need to make sure that our napkin does not absorb the colors. End of the day, they are the tissues, so they are going to absorb so much of color which you can't even imagine, and that might ruin your project. So just a thin coat, or if you want you can have a thicker coat, no harm in having a thicker coat. I always feel the more thicker varnish or the thicker sealer you put, that's really good for your project, and I really encourage that, to have thicker coat and the other options. Now with my tissue, I'm just dipping, trying to remove all the excessive varnish. Now this will make sure that it is not going to spread. Now I will use my heat gun to dry this up. The varnish what I'm using here is this one. This is a water-based varnish which I absolutely love, and I really recommend this one because I have been using this for my interiors and my exterior projects, like for my flower pots and everything, and it has never ever disappointed me till now. Yes, this is a clear varnish and this is a water-based varnish. Yes, Meena, there is a difference in a water-based varnish and the other varnish. So I will post a link after this where I have mentioned that why you need to have varieties of varnish for your different projects. There is a difference in that, and I hope that video will be helpful to you. Girls, again a little reminder, please do share this video as much as you can. Amina, these varnishes are easily available at any of the local hardware store. You really don't have to check anywhere. Just go to any good hardware store and you will get it. Now, another very important thing, many a times I have been asked, people say that if you can order it online, I would really suggest you not to order this online, because now these comes in a pack of 1 liter, so this is quite heavy. If you have to courier it, you will have to seal it really well, and that is going to make your courier charges a lot, so try to avoid that. Let me just dry it up on some of the corners too. Till then, if you guys have any queries, you can ask me. Vidhi, you can check Amazon, all the supplies are available. I'll share the link when the moment I'm done with this session. So I hope how to make your own modeling paste and texture paste was clear. Once again, I'll show you in the starting of the session, we have done this. So do check this session from starting if you have missed out anything on how to make your texture paste and your modeling paste. And I hope this will help you all. Now this is done. First, I am going to remove my excessive paper, and today I will not use any of the other tools. I will just trim this off. So if you don't have sandpaper, if you don't have nail filers, it's absolutely fine. You can just trim it down and this is good to go. The sandpaper is something which I would suggest you, but if you don't have, you can use your nail filer or you can just cut it down like this. Okay, now this is super easy. Water-based varnish means whenever you are using this varnish, you need to add 30% of the water. The link I will share later on. So girls, yes, now this is done. We are almost on the last few steps of our video today. Now this is an acrylic paint. Now on my previous video, I had shown you how to use your chalk paints, and today I wanted to show you how to use your acrylic paints. There is not much of difference when you have to use these shades. I'm adding some water to it. Why I'm adding water? Because I want to have a very nice shady effect on it. Now this is a spray which I'm using. It is a normal spray with a plain water on it. So I will be spraying some water and I will be blending in my color here. Make sure you don't overdo the water. Make sure you don't overdo the coloring work. This is just to highlight your texture work. That's it. Now can you see the beautiful color combination here? This is like a beautiful yellow and green and yellow color. If you don't have acrylic colors, you can use your chalk paints. It's absolutely fine. And if you even don't even have that, you can use your watercolor for sure. There is not going to be much of difference at all. End of the day, you should be happy that what kind of look and feel you want. And if you are getting that, it's absolutely fine, dear. Now I'm just brushing it up on some of the extra areas. Now I will be highlighting my texts like this. Later on, you will not even make out, like, we have added an extra paper beneath the decoupage napkin for the names. Girls, once again, I'll repeat, we have already covered how to make your texture paste and modeling paste in the starting of this session. So do check this video, this session, once we are finished from the starting, so that you don't miss out or anything. Okay, so here we are almost done. Guys, once again, I'll repeat, we have a huge giveaway with this session. So please do share this as much as you can. And again, we will be coming live at 3 o'clock, and we have a bumper giveaway. So please don't miss that. Okay girls, so this is done. This looks beautiful. And now again we need to use our heat gun to dry this up. Thank you so much, Alicia. Yes, of course, Yogita. The moment I finish up this live session, within a couple of minutes, this whole video will be live there on my page and you can check it as many times as you want. Thanks, Neha. Yes, even I'm also loving this so much. I love blue-yellow shade combinations and these are so nice and so tempting combinations which really... always attracts me. Like, these combinations have never ever let me down when it comes to making your own projects. Anubha, I know you have joined late, but once we are done with this live session, you can always check this video from the start, so don't worry about that. So right now you can see what we are doing now. Okay, so now here I have my black color acrylic paint. Now, why do I need my black color acrylic paint? Because if you see closely, this is a nameplate what we have made. Now, we need to highlight our names because they are hiding beneath our decoupage napkins. So, I have taken up a round thin brush. This is a triple zero brush. I've taken a black color acrylic paint on my lid and now I will just repeat this on my nameplate. Now before doing this acrylic paint step, you need to make sure that your napkin has dried out well, otherwise it is going to just merge everything. Very quickly I'll just run my heat gun once again. Yes, Vijeta, if you start this or see this video from the starting, you will know that I have used a plain printed paper, like on a normal print paper I have printed this one. Now if you want, you can do this step twice or thrice while making your nameplate and this will make sure that your names pops out really well. Thanks, Shubha, thank you so much. I'm glad that you liked it. I'm loving this too and I'm happy that today's session is also going so well. Girls, please do join us at 3 o'clock. We have something really interesting for you all and yes, we have a huge giveaway on our page, so please do share our post and this live session as much as you can. Vijeta, I've already mentioned that you can get all these varnish from any of the hardware store. I personally recommend to get the varnishes from the local store because the one which I use, they only come in a 1 kg 1 liter packaging. So if you are going to get this through courier, they are going to cost you bomb and I don't think that's worth it. Just go to the any good local hardware store and you will get it. If you don't have heat gun, you can use your hair dryer. It's going to work really well. So don't worry about that at all. Anything else you girls want to ask me, you can ask me. Thank you so much, Sonakshi. What's there at 3 o'clock? Sonia, we are going to have another video session and we are going to announce some nice surprises for our followers and this time it's not for one, it's not for two, it's for 5 people. So yes, for that you all will have to be there for 5 lucky winners giveaway we will be having on our page today again at 3 p.m. so do join us at 3 o'clock also. I hope you all like this nameplate. If you girls have any queries, you can comment below and I will be more than happy to help you all for sure. Yes, Sonakshi, even I'm so excited. I know it's going to be a really hectic session because one live sessions take at least 1 hour's time. So by the time I have my lunch again, I'll be back in front of my camera. But I'm super excited about it. Now this is super easy. I hope you all girls got it that creating your nameplate is not a really huge and tricky thing. This is really simple if you know how to play around with your material and how to have these some of the tips and tricks, and so you are good to go. So yes girls, with this our nameplate making is done. I really hope that you all liked it. Once again, I'll show you that in the starting of this video, we have made our own texture paste and modeling paste. So please do watch this video. If you have missed out, you can watch it again on my page and on my YouTube channel. And yes, of course, do share this video as much as you can. And here my nameplate is ready. I really hope that you all like this. Do let me know in the comment section below. Kavita is asking which type of napkin you have used. Kavita, I have used decoupage napkin. For the names, I have used the normal printout. Whenever you're using your normal printout, you have to be a little careful while sticking it and while using your other mediums, but it works out perfectly, so don't worry about that. Thank you so much, Ragini. Girls, we also have a Facebook group where we love watching your work too, so please do check our group Growing Craft where you can join and share your projects, and we would love to see that. Oh, thank you, Sapna. I really miss out so many queries while doing this session, but definitely once we are done, I will share up all the links on my page and you can check that. And if you join our group, you can check there too. Yes, Neha, this is completely waterproof. Once this alphabet dries out, I'm going to give good 2-3 coats of varnish to it, which is really, really important. Make sure whenever you're using your making your decoupage and mixed media project, you use a good quality varnish and do a good 2-3 coats of varnish for sure. Thank you so much, Mini. Thank you so much. I'm so glad and I'm so happy to see all those lovely comments and feedbacks. So girls, I think we are done for today, and please do join us at 3 o'clock today because we have another live session with a huge bumper giveaway for one, not two, but for 5 people. And yes, I'm sure you're going to like it, and please do share this video as much as you can because we have a giveaway for this live session also. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Take care and see you again at 3 o'clock. Take care. Bye-bye. Deux doigts de nos lèvres, deux doigts si fins que j'ai presque pu le goûter, le bonheur à sculpter.